it says so much about their humanity that in a moment when they were grieving the loss of their son, they were called upon in such a selfless way to comfort not just everyone around them, their friends and family, but an entire community and an entire nation, really.
You with the saddest.
You know, they say never get between a mother bear and her cub. And when Matthew died, Judy became a mother for all of us.
And this was a woman who basically, you could tell, was containing her fury over what happened to her son and trying to harness it to do something. I thought that I couldn't respect or care about Judy more, and then I became a mother. And when I became a mother, I realized just how much she sacrificed and how much she's doing for us.
She never gave up. She never gave in. She never became bitter or hostile.
This year, Judy Shepard spoke passionately in front of the House Democratic Caucus. And even to the extent Jim Clyburn was so moved by her remarks, he said later at an HRC event that changed him. That changed the way he viewed his role as the majority whip.
I think I've seen it most on Capitol Hill with members of Congress. You know, they're looking for someone with whom they can identify.
Judy and Dennis were able to put a face on what hate would do.
The truth is, people like Judy and Dennis Shepard are voices that can never be created, you know, from the LGBT community itself. We must have straight voices, and there are no two voices that are more important and authentic than Judy and Dennis's.
Imagine if every LGBT kid in this country growing up had a father like Dennis Shepard.
When the dad stands up and he's got jeans and, you know, a cowboy shirt and boots on and says, I loved my son unconditionally. I loved him for who he was. I think that means a tremendous amount.
Judy and Dennis had made a lasting contribution to the gay community, saying to gay, lesbian, transgender, bisexual individuals, it's all right. It's okay to be yourself. Don't be afraid.
I'll never forget the day that we held a press conference, Ted Kennedy and myself. And I asked Judy's permission right before that press conference if she would do us the honor of giving this statue the name of her son. Matthew Shepard will live on in the lives of many people and on the books of the United States statutes.
No two individuals are better deserving of being honored in the name of Ted Kennedy than the two of you.
Don't be afraid. Let them show your true colors, your true